Well, you just sitting pretty right there with all your drinks.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner right here.
It's perfect.
Love
all
it.
In a drink. Drink your calories. If you've always wanted to kiss a leprechaun, now's your chance. Here to explain and pucker up, lifestyle blogger with Cake and Confetti, Meredith Staggers. Welcome back.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I'm excited to be here.
So we should mention, this is an adult-only beverage.
Yes.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, this is
there's
really
one
fun.
You can make kid-friendly.
Okay.
We'll start with the sangria.
Okay. Which one? We're going to make sangria first. So if you want to start with your breakfast.
Okay.
So
I've got the easy job.
Yes, absolutely. So we layered in some different colors of fruit to kind of create the rainbow. So if you want to start with that, Courtney.
Sure. Am I putting it in the
in
mason?
This one?
In this one. Okay.
And that's going to be the sangria mixture.
Am I putting it all in or just a couple?
Just like, yeah, that's good.
Okay.
And then just then you can do the kiwi. Pineapple. You know,
and I like
Roy G. Biv. Thing,
oh, yes,
you know?
Yes.
You can add any fruit that like go or that match the color scheme.
Right.
This is so tasty, by the way.
It
I
is?
Feel guilty that I'm already enjoying it before you're making it.
Well, I'm glad you like it. Cheers.
Oh, gosh.
You're good. You're good.
Okay.
Okay, so that's, so now we're going to make the sangria mixture. So you're going to take, fill up about half with the dry white wine.
Okay, and we did a Pinot Grigio here.
Yeah. Yeah,
very nice.
Any that you like. That's good.
Okay.
Then you're going to do a splash of brandy. The brandy's optional if you just want to have more of like a wine spritzer.
That was probably more of a pour.
That's good. Sorry. I like your style. And a little bit of sparkling water.
Topo.
I love topo.
Is that
nice
good?
And fizzy. That's perfect.
Okay.
And then we're going to finish off with a little bit of honey.
Fabulous.
And then you're going to stir that all up.
Okay.
And the honey sort of cuts some of the bitterness, too, because with sangria, Meredith, isn't it true that you have to kind of leave it sometimes
kind
to let
marinate.
It soak up?
Absolutely. In this, you definitely could, and a lot of the fruit would soak up some of the alcohol, and then you just pour it in there.
Ooh, look at that measurement, Derrick.
That was perfect.
It's like I made a cocktail once before.
Yeah.
That's right.
Who and
knew?
Then just stick the little straw in there, and it'll help some of the fruit float to the top.
After the, what is it? At the end of the rainbow is a pot of gold?
And hopefully a leprechaun, too.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. Okay.
Oh, that's nice.
Isn't that great? That's a home run.
This is definitely how fun to do like a girl's brunch or something. That would be fantastic.
Don't you love all the, like the gradient layers, too?
I love it.
Super cute.
Yeah,
that
you could freeze the fruit if you like, you know, if you're going to enjoy it outside.
Right.
And then you could just add it in so it'll keep it nice and cool.
What a fun summer drink. I love that. Start with St. Patty's Day and let it roll on through.
Actually,
okay.
These are all good for Pride Month, too, in June.
Absolutely.
It's perfect.
Yeah. Okay, move along to lunch, okay? Breakfast,
okay.
Lunch.
Okay. So the next is the Leprechaun's Kiss Martini. So I'm going to have you line the glass. So first you're going to turn it over into the honey.
Oh.
And just...
kind of a little dipper there, right?
And then we're going to do the sprinkles. So there's some gold stars in there and rainbow sprinkles.
Oh,
you can really do
cute.
Any sprinkles that you like, but
what a great
I like
idea
everything.
To use honey.
Yeah. Yeah, so then whenever you're tasting it, there's like a little sweetness.
Oh,
awesome.
He's very quiet over there. He's very quiet. Okay.
So then next you're going to drop in your little Hershey Kiss for the, you know, kind of like those like ice cream cones that has the little treat at the bottom.
In the middle. Uh-huh.
And then, so this is a shaker that already has the mixture in it.
Okay.
There's chocolate liqueur, cream de cacao, vanilla vodka. It is pretty boozy. And then some Irish cream.
Oh, I...
liqueur.
I didn't think it tasted boozy at all.
Oh, you don't?
We like boozy.
I wasn't sure there was booze in it.
Oh, well, there is. And then, so yeah, you just fill it up and...
Wow.
This is so cute. Maybe this was should have been dessert, no?
Dude, this is...
super good.
A slam dunk.
Good, I'm so
it's delicious.
Glad. Cheers.
Okay. Cheers, my friend.
Cheers. What a colorful and fun idea.
Yeah.
But your Instagram is so much fun to watch. Speaking of colorful, you have one of the prettiest Instagram pages I've ever seen.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you know, St. Patty's Day, green is great, but then also adding in the pops of rainbow makes it so fun, too.
And the little kiss surprise at the bottom, too. I didn't even realize there was a kiss there.
Okay, keep talking.
So
I'm going to sip. Okay, go ahead.
So this, the next one is a boozy Lucky Charms milkshake.
Oh, my gosh.
So this one is super fun. You know, the over-the-top desserts are very...
They're a big thing.
Yes.
Very IG friendly.
They are.
Okay, so what do you have in here already?
I crushed up some of the Lucky Charms marshmallows. I just put them in a little bag and just used a little bottom of a glass to make it more of a powder.
Okay.
And I added vanilla vodka, vanilla ice cream, and some milk in here. And then we're gonna go ahead, make sure it's on there tight.
Yeah, I know, right? Every time you say vanilla ice, so it makes me wanna dance.
Okay. So just give it a nice little mix.
Okay, did you actually separate these from the cereal?
Yeah.
That, I hope you drank one of those while you were doing that. That's a lot of work.
Yeah, so then I'm gonna just pour this one.
Look at how cute that is. Do you love it?
Obviously, the ice cream is it's been out for a little bit, so
okay,
a little bit more watery than normal,
right? But TV purposes,
yeah, you could always add some ice, and so give this a nice little topper on here.
Oh, okay. So what was in your mixture? I'm sorry, we had
you had
the cereal pieces?
Milk, the cereal pieces. We used this cake vodka. It asked for marshmallow vodka, but I couldn't find it.
Okay,
so,
let me smell that.
It actually smells really nice.
Oh, it does. Okay.
So we have all of that in there, and then we just blended it
together. Okay. Did we top it with anything?
We topped it with, we have the whipped cream, and then here are some fun Lucky Charms pieces to just add on there. And I always like sprinkles, too.
Oh, so. Yeah, girl. You've got to. You're cake and confetti.
I know. So just kind of, you know, and then put a little couple colorful marshmallows, because at this point you cannot have enough sugar.
Right.
And then
the cotton candy?
The cotton candy.
Yes.
Fun little.
Meredith, I love it.
These are awesome. Thank you so much. They're delicious. Courtney, what do you think?
Oh, that's good.
That is like
that
a milkshake.
That is really good.
Forget the Coke milk. Go for the unicorn.
Yeah,
make this.
Yeah, I'd
yes,
have to agree.
Absolutely.
That was awesome. Well, listen, guys, as always, if you want to connect with Meredith, we have a Scene on Houston Life section on our website, houstonlife.tv. Cheers. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Cheers.
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 They're so delicious. Seriously, try making these at home.
Here you go. Cheers, my friend.